What up, guys? This is Lyrics.
This is JL.
And we go by the ear of the ox.
And this is our new music video for Viral. Check it out.
Enjoy.
Gotta be honest on this track, so I wanna be earnest. After 9/11, I remember seeing turbans and getting nervous. My friend called me out and said I'm being an ignorant person. Said I was being racist, I had to take it cause I deserved it. Listen, I wanna be honest, so I give you facts. My uncle had a deli and every week he's getting jacked. And 9 out of 10 times he stick up kids, they happen to be black. That's why I scream and hurry up and buy with his hand on his strap. Look, if I wanna be heard, can't forget the balance. I mean, we're racist to a point, but here's the bigger challenge. Why do we group people together and only focus on the minuses? Scared of pandemics, but hate is stronger than any viruses. Think I'm dealing with racism worse because of the outbreak? No, we've been dealing with racism since birth with outbreaks. I still have faith in humankind, but what do I know? Hatred's the most contagious, and these days it's going viral.
I hate Asians. Look, uh-oh, he's scared, OG. Crack your
This morning I told my mama to watch her back cause they out to get us. Their plan of attack is like that of the clan but without the getter. Paranoid and ignorant is a dangerous combination. They wanna blame someone so they aim it at all the Asians. I saw the clips of them getting kicked and it got me livid. What is this time that we live in? What kind of society is this? There isn't a limit to the lengths they'll go for a viral image. And hatred may be permitted still but violence isn't. All this is showing us how dark it is that we've become. Showing us how weak you are by targeting the weakest one. They weren't asking for problems, still they looked at him awkward. Wearing a mask out of caution and now look what it cost them. And it's an issue, I know it's something to iterate. Even if they continue to, Corona doesn't discriminate. The state of danger is getting drastic, it's about survival. But hate and anger's been spreading faster and now it's viral. Viral, 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 viral.
Makes people do crazy things, your mind switch to auto. If I die, then everyone dies, it becomes the motto. You locking me in my house, and my freedom's what you fucking with. Then fuck you, I'm leaving every elevator button lit. You try to throw my cousin in a box, then you broke her neck. Separated families, the phone's out, now it won't connect. That's why I hate you, spit on your face, show no respect. Left us out to die, no one heard our cries, cause no one's left. You know the story, Asian boy, bully, chink boy, small dick boy. And nowadays they call him sick boy, they quarantine him at school. You know how kids do it, this point his spirit destroyed. After school goes to his dad's desk drawer and finds the pistol. Loads it shaking so much and just points at himself while crying fuck everybody that I know. Am I the only one right now is feeling suicidal? And he shoots himself in the face and he dies and it goes viral.
Look, we're gonna have other comments of a similar tone. All over the United States we're seeing cases of individuals that have been in China, and many of them are ethnic Chinese, so you may feed a kind of racial response, a kind of xenophobia that is always in America, just, you know, this close to the surface. Give it a little scratch and boom, out comes the racism. So I think we're in very dangerous territory right now, where we need not only infrastructure guidance but moral guidance in how to respond to a frightening epidemic.
Hey everyone, I just want to say thanks again to Year of the Ox for letting us share this video and this message with you all. Thank you guys again for, first of all, making this song and, you know, taking it upon yourselves to pass on this message. I've always been a supporter of you guys and your music and your mission. Obviously, these are really difficult times for Asians in America and Western countries around the world. It's always risky to talk about politics, on social media, especially on our channel, where we don't really dive into this stuff very often. But, you know, everything that's going on right now in the world kind of just hits a little bit too close to home in our community. And especially the fact that mainstream media is like barely talking about the violent attacks and harassment on Asians. Wong Fu had to use our platform to spread awareness, and that it's our responsibility to use our voice to combat the ignorance that's out there. And you guys did such an amazing job taking so many complex emotions and issues and putting them into verse and song. So maybe just start off by, you know, telling us like your process of making this song.
Well, first of all, I just want to say thank you for giving us the platform. You know what I mean? This is a hard time for all of us. As far as our process though, like just seeing the clips and everything, I think that really just, it made this one a lot easier for me to write, at least. Like it kind of just came out really easy this time. And
we were overwhelmed with just the amount of stories and examples of things that are happening all around the world, not only in America, you know? And when we saw that, you know, we didn't want to put on the cape and be like, okay, we gotta be the superheroes and talk about it. But we had to speak for the voiceless, you know? We had to do something where not only protect, I guess, our people, our brothers and sisters, but also bring awareness and another perspective.
Were you guys worried at all about any kind of like backlash about it?
Yeah, for sure, 100%. Like, because we didn't want to incite anything. We didn't want this to be like a gasoline track. We weren't trying to add to the fire and make the flame bigger. And especially when we made a song, like a video where we compiled different clips of things going on, but we wanted to make sure that everything that we put on was relevant.
We just wanted to speak on it. I think more with the video, it was more like we had to pay more attention. With our verses, it kind of just came out, you know, the way that we wanted it to.
So lyrics, like the song starts off with actually you calling out your own past prejudices, and I thought that was important. I guess I just am wondering if you can expand on that choice.
100%. We had to write it in a way where I didn't come straight off the jump attacking them.
You know right. What
I
mean?
If I'm making a song about let's be aware and let's, you know, not be so ignorant, I didn't want to place myself on a higher pedestal and tell people like, you know, this is how you're supposed to do it. The best way to come out is like, before anything, I'm at fault, you know? This song is not directed to you. I'm speaking for me too. I'm speaking for all of us. I wanted that first verse to be it's okay. We understand why some of these assaults are happening. Maybe it's not even malicious intent that you have. Maybe it's just fear. Maybe it's real, genuine worry and it's coming out this right. way. And it was a very risky right. move, but I felt like that was a prerequisite before we start the song.
It is necessary for us to, you know, acknowledge it first on our side before we start pointing fingers. JL, you know, in the second verse, if you can talk a little bit about, do you feel like this level of racism is different from maybe what Asians have been experiencing in the past? Because it's not like there hasn't been racism towards Asians, you know, before this, right?
Yeah, no, and like, I feel like my verse sounded a little bit more angrier than Rick's did. Like, it is different because it's out of fear and ignorance and, like, anger, and they're kind of just, you know, it's an issue where, like, you can't be pointing fingers at this point, and you can't be like, you know, hating on a certain thing because of a certain race or whatever. And like, we wanted to make sure we were very careful with that too, because we're not the first ones to be discriminated.
If we want to talk about not being racist and that, like, that's such a very tall cup to drink, you know, like, yeah, just to say it like that. We do worry about our parents going out in the public right now and getting jumped or mugged, because we see this all the time, you know, especially now. I feel like JL's verse was, he was just reporting the situation, you know, not trying to be too biased, but accurately portraying what's going on, and not to incite fear, but let people know that this is our daily reality right
yeah.
now.
You're trying to reason, he came in, you know, with the realities. And then your third verse actually brings up retaliation and response and like what happens now. And actually one part of the song that really spoke out to me was, I actually have been thinking a lot about the kids. It makes me sad thinking that there might be some Asian kids out there that are getting bullied, that might be pushed to an extreme level, or even just start self-hating themselves.
We could have easily ended the track by saying we will retaliate on others, but we wanted to let people know that this is like a preventive measure. Let's stop doing this because we don't want our youth to hurt themselves or feel so low about themselves. It's going to affect them forever. You know what I mean? Yeah. Our hearts went out to the young kids right now because we can't even imagine. You know how savage and kids are.
How do you think we as a community should respond? What would you want people to take away from this video and song?
We got to find a way to, you know, bring everybody closer and you know, not to sound cliche, but love is really, you know, gonna help us get over this, at least this part of it, you know, this hatred and this anger that's coming out of ignorance and fear. Like there has to be a way to get over that. And I think, you know, just being open-minded and not ignorant to everything.
Racism doesn't fight racism. That's for sure, right?
And even though it's a small sample size of it, just looking at some of the comments and you know, there's not a lot of negative comments. There's a lot of people who are being uplifting and coming together too, even just in our comment section. So I think, you know.
Phil, the greatest comments that we've been saying on our video, there are people that are coming clean and saying, you know what, this song made me think about how racist I used to be. But for them to really self-reflect and not feel threatened and not feel disrespected, and then to leave the comments and, you know what, I too was messed up back then, that is, to me, is progress.
Well, thank you guys again for putting it out there, and thanks for sharing it with us, guys.
Nah, you will appreciate it.
Take it easy, guys.
For sure. Thanks for the platform, buddy.
For sure. Thanks again to Year of the Ox for that amazing video, and thank you to you guys for watching. I hope you guys got something out of it and feel inspired and empowered. Please send it to someone to help spread awareness. In the meantime, it is definitely some crazy times that we're going through right now, but I know we'll get through it together. Just look out for one another, and also listen to the professionals and the experts, and that means social distancing and washing your hands, and just be kind to each other. One last thing, the situation that we're all in right now is affecting a lot of small businesses, and that includes Wong Fu Productions. A lot of things are up in the air right now, so if you want to help us during this time, this is where our Patreon really makes a big difference, so please consider joining that community there. You can even make a one-time contribution if you don't want to join monthly, but it would make a big difference for us. For now, stay safe out there, stay calm, and don't be racist. See you guys.